Well, good morning and welcome back. I am Catherine Kiernan with Aspire Realty, and this is your Monday Morning Coffee Talk. It has been awesome how much feedback we have been getting from you guys as you've been seeing videos and then emailing in or asking questions. And we want to make sure that we touch on all of them. This time is made especially for you, for any person looking to buy, sell, or invest in real estate in the Fargo, Moorhead, and surrounding areas. We want to make sure that we're giving you the information that people are itching to know. So without further ado, for the next couple of segments, we're going to focus all on the FAQs. It's the most frequently asked questions that we see. And so bear with me. And if you have a topic in mind that is of particular interest to you as well, let us know. Send us a message and we'd be happy to do a piece on it, because if you're thinking it, other people are thinking it too. So, first question, in today's local real estate market, would it be better to build or buy pre-existing? Here's the deal. I am a new construction junkie myself. I love that process. I love the consult process with clients too, and being able to build for clients the exact property that they want and making their visions come to reality is so much fun. And there's no shaking the stick at that, right? However, there are additional costs. You're paying retail when you're building. And so things to be mindful of is a realistic expectation of what you're willing to spend and able to spend, and is what you have envisioned in your mind in accordance or in line with what your actual budget is. And so that's where we really sit down. We look at doing a new buyer consult. And we look at all of those different facts and features, like, okay, well, we want this, 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 and this in this particular area of town, and here's how much we have to work with. If it works within the budget to do new construction, absolutely. It's the best way to get exactly what you want. However, sometimes that budget is the number one factor, and with that being the case, then we look for something pre-existing that has the potential of making some nice improvements to it at a really great price point, to still get you, big picture-wise, what you want, but maybe on a more friendly budget, if that makes sense. If you have additional questions, or if I can feed off of that a little bit more, let me know. But thanks so much for sending in your question. Next question. Do I need a pre-approval letter in order to tour homes I'm interested in? So, legally speaking, no, you don't. However, we do buyer consults with all of our buyers before we get in the active process of looking at homes with you. And the number one recommendation that we have is to get pre-approved. I cannot tell you how many times I've said that until I swear I'm blue in the face, and buyers haven't done it. And then we find them the most perfect house for them, and they want to write an offer. So now we're moving like the wind to put that offer together, but we aren't submitting it without a pre-approval. And then they go to their lender to find that maybe there is an income restriction that's getting in their way or some other factor, and they're not able to get those funds. And that is the most disappointing phone call to have to make. So in your best interest, absolutely get pre-approved. If you don't know how to get that process started or who to talk to, that's what we're here for. So you can fire away any questions that you have and we'll help walk you through that process. Really good questions today. I love this. Another one. So I had a client the other day who was like, when I'm watching Selling Sunset, what does it mean when they get all excited and saying, we opened up escrow? Well, escrow is typically, well, it is what happens when we have an intermediary. So typically it's the listing agent, or it can be a title company, is holding the earnest money funds for the contracts that both the buyer and the seller have agreed to. So it can be anywhere from $1,000 to the sky is the limit. It just kind of depends on the property. So when you write that earnest money check and everybody has the legally binding contract signed by both parties, then that check goes to that third party company. Like I said, most times it's either title company, lawyer, or a listing brokerage. And then they'll hold those funds for safekeeping until we get to the closing table. And then those funds are applied back to the transaction. So, well, that's what we have for today. I want to be respectful of your time. I'm so grateful. Keep sending in the questions. We love doing these segments, and you have to keep an eye on some of our videos. We're going to be bringing in some really great new agents that we have on the team, as well as our lending partners. So lots more information coming your way. Have the best week. I look forward to seeing you next week.